thoughts upon a midnight dreary, as I pondered weak and weary over a many quaint and curious volume of forgotten lore. While I nodded, nearly napping, tapping. As of someone gently rapping, rapping at my chamber door. 'Tis some visitor, I muttered, tapping at my chamber. December, and each separate dying ember wrought its ghost upon the floor. Eagerly I wished the morrow. Vainly I had sought to borrow from my books surcease of sorrow. Napping, and so gently you came rapping, and so faintly you came tapping, tapping at my chamber door, that I scarce was sure I heard you. Here I opened wide the door. Darkness there, and nothing more. Darkness peering, long I stood there wondering, fearing, doubting, dreaming dreams no mortal ever dared to dream before. But the silence was unbroken, and the darkness gave no token, and the only word there spoken was the whispered word, "Lun." I whispered, and an echo murmured back the word, "Lenore." Merely this and nothing more. Back into the chamber turning, all my soul within me burning, soon somewhat louder than before. "Surely," said I, "surely that is something at my window lattice. Let me see then what thereat is, and this mystery explore. Let my heart be still a moment, and this mystery explore." "'Tis the wind and nothing more. Open here I flung the shutter, when with many a flirt and flutter, in there stepped a stately raven of the saintly days of yore. Not the least obeisance made he, not an instant stopped or stady, but with mien of lord or lady perched above my chamber door, perched above a bust of Pallas just above my chamber door, perched and sat and nothing more. Then this ebony bird beguiling my sad fancy into smiling, by the grave and stern decorum of the countenance it wore. Though thy crest be shorn and shaven, thou, I said, art sure no craven, ghastly, grim, and ancient raven, wandering from the nightly shore. Tell me what thy lordly name is in the night's Plutonian shore." Blessed with seeing bird above his chamber door, bird or beast upon the sculptured bust above his chamber door, with such name as Nevermore. But the raven sitting lonely on the placid bust spoke only that one word, as if his nothing farther than he uttered, not a feather than he fluttered, till I scarcely more than muttered, "Other friends have flown before. On the morrow he will leave me as my hopes have flown before." Then the bird said, smiling, straight and wheeled a cushioned seat in front of bird and bust and door. Then upon the velvet seeking, I betook myself to linking fancy unto fancy, thinking what this ominous bird of yore, what this grim, ungainly, ghastly, gaunt and ominous bird of yore, meant in croaking Thus I sat engaged in guessing, but no syllable expressing, to the fowl whose fiery eyes now burned into my bosom's core. This and more I sat divining, with my head at ease reclining on the cushion's velvet lining that the lamplight gloated o'er. But whose velvet violet lining with the lamplight gloating o'er shall press, ah, never, never more. Then methought the air grew denser, perfumed from an unseen censer. Of Lenore. Quaff, oh, quaff. This kind nepenthe and forget this lost Lenore. Quoth the raven, nevermore. Prophet, said still, if bird or devil, whether tempter sent or whether tempest tossed thee here ashore, desolate yet still undaunted on this desert land enchanted, on this home by horror haunted, tell me truly, I implore, is there balm in Gilead? Tell me, I implore.
Still is sitting on the pallid bust of Pallas just above my chamber door, and his eyes have all the seeming of a demon's that is dreaming, and the lamplight o'er his streaming throws his shadow on the floor. and my soul from out that shadow that lies floating on the floor shall be lifted.